guys. Today I'm on Lucia's channel. Make sure you check it out.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm with Danielle. Danny Frimpong.
Yes. We're gonna be doing makeup today, so like a prom look. So.
A prom inspired look. Yeah. I know like a lot of you guys have it's got prom coming season, up, so you know you wanna be fleet, beat up, yeah. Anything, cooked, whatever you wanna call it.
Yeah. I'm excited. I'm
happy I'm to get
excited.
This face beat to get my nose contoured for the first time.
My skin is flawless anyway, so it's not even.
I'm gonna tell you my morning routine, so what I've done to my face so far. So I showered this morning and I used this Morning Energy Clean and Clear Skin Energising Daily Facial Scrub, and it's oil free because I've got really, really oily skin. Then I used the Garnier Skin Natural Fresh Refining Toner and it's Shine Be Gone. And this kind of like just kind of re-cleans my face, and I don't know, if I don't use this, I don't feel like I've really showered or like I've really washed my face. And then I use this Garnier Pure Active something hydrant 24 hour cream. I never used to cream my face before because I've got such oily skin. I thought if I cream it, it's making it worse, but if you don't cream your face, apparently it's worse than creaming it because your skin gets so dry that it produces more oil and you like have oilier skin. So yeah, let's get started, guys.
First, First, I'm using NYX's like Shine Killer. Like it's what's it called? It's a primer. You can use it alone if you, You can use it alone if you want to, but it's called Shine Killer, so it's for not for oily skin, but you know during the day and stuff you might get really oily or makeup doesn't look nice, it stops that from happening. So I'm gonna use it on her today.
Is it like a primer?
Yeah.
Okay.
But you can use it alone. I'm gonna go in with an angled brush. It's just a Barry M one to do her like
You didn't do the YouTube makeup girl thing.
Oh,
I'm gonna go in. That's what they do. They do this as if like I don't know if it's the lighting behind that's gonna hit the brush or something. But yeah, this is it, guys.
I'm Barry M. I wrap them for.
Can't wait to get beat. Where did the word beat come from? And like
I don't know.
Cooking and stuff.
Cooking. I know cooking. Like, do you know, obviously, when you're cooking something, you wait for it to heat up, to set, to be ready.
Yeah.
That's where that sort of came from. I don't know where it originated from, anything, but I think it's an American thing.
Yeah, that's
when they leave their banana and set powder.
Yeah, that's when that's
set, so it just sit. So it's like to let it sink into the skin a bit.
Okay.
And you're gonna get an eyebrow pencil. You can literally use any one. This one's called Vital. I got it the other day and it's really good. It's from that hair shop, whatever. It's only £1. It's waterproof. It's a dark brown. Then I'm gonna go with that and I'm gonna go over spoolie. I use fresh ones each time for my client.
I didn't even know that was called a spoolie.
And I'm just gonna brush her eyebrows out, then outline it. Then after, I'm gonna go in with a dip brow pomade. And this one's by, I don't know if you can, let me show you. It's by, I don't know if you can see it, guys, but it's Anastasia Beverly Hills.
And Anastasia Beverly Hills.
It's in dark brown, it's waterproof and it's so sick. Like, it sits really well.
Do you think it's better to use dark brown or black for eyebrows?
Oh, don't do stop it. Just don't do that. But do you know what? Yeah, let me, like, sometimes I'll do my eyebrows, but if I want them darker, I might get mascara.
And fill it in, yeah.
No, not fill it in, like, use just with the ends, I'll gently brush. Like,
okay.
Let me give you an example. So I might get black mascara and I'll gently do this, only so the edges are darker.
Okay, natural, yeah.
But you can't have black coming in. No, but some girls do have black eyebrows though. Like some of them work
some
with
them
like,
works,
brown
yeah.
pencil, but you can see the black. So you need to, you know, use black if you got black eyebrows. I think I hear my gym coming in. Whoa, whoa, whoa. This my gym coming in. Angled brush from Wilkinson's and it's only £1, so calm. I use that to fill in the brows.
It's a nice color. Hey. Think it's a game.
When you want to conceal your brows, you can sometimes use a lighter shade. Oh, thank you. Yeah, sometimes you can use a lighter shade underneath to sort of highlight. But let me just see if this is your colour. So I've got the LA Pro Girl.
Typical YouTuber.
Concealer. But this is in chestnut. Yeah, this shade is in chestnut. Let me see if this is your Okay, great. I'm going to use this because it's like her face colour kind of. So I'm going to use that to highlight. No, not highlight. I'm going to use it above and below her brow. I don't want too much of a, you know, huge highlight. I still want the look to look a bit natural, especially because with the eyeshadow we're going a bit, you know, so we need to conceal. So I usually start from the bottom, like 3/4 out, and then I gently add product to the brow. And I go in like slight quick motions. Because if you go too slow, you might mess it up. But really, as you're going, push the concealer up as you're, you know, going. So because it's going to dry out.
Oh, so it's easier to blend, right?
Yeah. So as you can see, her eyebrow shape has been formed. So there's a little bit here, I just need to fill in a bit. So like, if anything, you need to fill in a certain bit more, you can do that. And brush the front out. Then sort of blend the front out where you need to. And then I'm gonna take my Real Techniques. It's called a small foundation brush, but I use it for blending out the concealer.
So, do you know that I use one brush for everything?
What do you mean? What do you mean for everything?
Like I use, I use one brush for my foundation and then I use another one for my, to like blend my concealer.
That's kind of, that's all you need though for that, for the,
I know, foundation. People are like, you need like 15 brushes. I'm like, no. I don't have 15 things, different things to do.
Now what I'm doing is that I'm just blending it out. So with the bottom, you want to blend and then like pull it down for the bottom. You don't want any harsh light. We're not trying to do halo eyebrows, girls. No, stop it. And then we want to do the same around the eye. And make sure, around the eyebrow, make sure that you're not hitting the eyebrow because you'll mess it up. So you have to be at work fast so it doesn't jive, but be precise. Yeah. So just keep blending. But you don't need to blend too tough because after when I do her foundation, I'm going to sort of cover over that. So don't worry about it too much.
Do you have to do your eyebrows before the foundation or can you do it all the way?
No, like before I was started doing makeup, I didn't, but it is best too, because I feel like everything just blends in after. You can blend in your foundation stuff easier, and if you mess up your eyebrows, yeah, you've done your foundation's peak, you have to start all over again.
That's true.
So that's what I like to do. Baby, take it slow, make her feel her. Feel her, baby, make her feel alright. Can you make me wonder how you feel so tight? And baby girl, you make my day so bright. Baby girl, you make me feel alright. Feel alright. You want the money, you want the money. Baby, suffer for me, show you feeling me. Tell me, is it me? You got me feeling. Baby, let me take my time. I wanna make you mine. I wanna make you mine. Yeah, you're on my mind. I said you're on my mind. And now I'm gonna prime her eyelids. It's important so that your eyeshadow doesn't crease and it'll stay on all day. I'm using the Urban Decay's Prime Potion. I've got the sample pack at the moment that came with my Naked palette. So. Wave. Okay. So we're at this stage where her eyes just primed. Then we're going with the eyeshadow.
So what colour are we doing today?
Okay, so we're doing like a brown with a purple, dark purple crease, and then gold on the I'm gonna go in with.
How do I look, guys?
I'm gonna use a pencil brush, it's one of my Zoeva brushes, to do her crease. Hallelujah. Chap chap in the bando, I don't wanna look like you. Chap chap in the bando, I don't wanna look like you. Chap 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 chap, look like you. No, I don't wanna look like you.
like you. Chap chap in the bando, I don't wanna look like you. Chap chap in the bando, I don't wanna look like you. Chap in the bando, look like you.
I'm gonna go with the banana
for my eyebrows or for the eyeshadow.
Oh my gosh, no, to like set like your brow bone.
Do you prefer banana or topaz?
For what?
For yourself.
Like, is it for my highlight?
For your like concealer, your under eye
concealer. Oh, okay. I mix them. Before I used to use banana, and I think that looks ashy. So I mix
it makes me when I use just banana, it makes me look too white or like I'm bleached.
Yeah. Other than that, I set the eyebrows with any cream. So like you can use a setting brow setting, but obviously mine's got those.
Yeah.
Stuff, but I just set them so they don't move. Okay, this is the Inglot 77 gel liner. Comes like this. I think it's like £15 or something like that. It's really good, but it's waterproof. So it's very hard to get off. So sorry, but it's gonna be very hard. It's the Rimmel Accelerator.
I used to have that.
Endless, but I use like an applicator stick so that my clients don't get. I'm gonna let you rub this on, yeah? So I'm gonna put it on 4 spots of the face. You don't need too much primer. If you put too much, it just messes up the base of your makeup and your foundation will become all funny.
Can I put cream on before I use this primer, or should I just use it as a cream as well?
No, you can put, like I said, you already put cream.
You can put cream as well if you
want. Yeah, I would put cream first. I'll still moisturize my face. Right, rub it all in. Wait, hold on. Let's do. Right, rub it all in the full areas. Like. Okay, now I'm gonna go in with the Lancome Tint. It's really good. It's a matte foundation.
So it's an oil free.
I'm gonna use the Zariba Petite Stippling. Do you wanna do your little thing? Petite Stippling brush as well. This is great. If you want full coverage or good coverage, you use a stippling brush. If you want not so much, you use a beauty blender. It's just the Real Techniques.
What's stippling? The way the brush is?
Yeah, so it says, yeah, stippling brush.
Okay.
Yeah. So, with the foundation, I just generally like to do a few blotches. Every day we grind on the curb. Yeah. Cause if you want to live life, money first. Oh man.
Every day we grind on the curb. Yeah. Why do you do neck?
So it blends. It blends
in
well.
Do you do front and back?
No, just like to side about where your ear hits to here. Say you're taking pictures at, I don't know, it's a wedding or something, you're gonna have side shot view, so you need to hit where your ear is and bring it down to the side of your neck. And then sort of blend to the bottom of your chest. Not too much foundation, but if you just blend it out, it'll come out all evenly, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Other side. It's really important because you don't want that line, or you don't want people to be like, her face is
Yeah.
Half the time it's not even the case. It's just that if you don't do your chest, it's just gonna look a different colour by default. It's important to blend.
Sometimes you blend when you go out, you just see that you didn't really do a great
100.
Job.
It's peak.
And
or flash.
Just like, oh shit.
Flash will tell you. Okay, so I'm putting a tiny bit of foundation on the little brush I used before. Remember I said that obviously you have to blend, but you don't have to burn too tough if you can go over it with foundation. So I'm using the foundation to sort of blend it in with the, blend the concealer in with the foundation a bit. That's what I'm doing. It'll still look a little bit lighter than this then, but more blended out. You're already looking fine as ever. Good skin's glowing already. Okay, after that, I'm gonna go with, what's it called? What curl do I want to use? I'm gonna go with the LA Pro Girl concealers. I don't know if I'm going to use toffee or fawn. I'm rather deciding right now. I might use a mixture of both. Really and truly, just go with
I use fawn, but I think I'm maybe toffee.
I'm highlighting her face using the LA Pro Girl concealer. Yeah, so I'm going to do like her chin, then her cupid's bow area. I better go, yeah. And then her nose.
I really don't know enough about makeup. I don't know what's the difference between highlight and contour.
Contour is to add dimension to your face, highlight is to brighten certain areas.
Finish up my day with a light, be like a night runs out money. No, no, no. Money, 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 money. I refuse to be broken by me. Yeah. That's not even funny.
Techniques, complexion sponge. And I'm using my Frix Plus. I'm just spraying a bit of that from there to hydrate her face. And also, you can't use a beauty blender dry. Well, you're not supposed to. So, okay, if you look up. So when you're using the beauty blender, you're supposed to press into the skin, not drive across the skin.
I've been getting money on a low. Girl, you should come to my house. Big face, rolling for the wrist. I left it home on the couch. Even though a nigga don't show it, everything you see, you know I own it. I never been the type to go and blow it. I'm the type of nigga that will hold it down. Finger and money on the low. Everything you see, you know I own it. I've never been the type to go and blow it. I've been getting money on the low. Look at you, look at me stuck in these clothes. I ain't even turned up yet, I ain't gone home.
I feel like a bride.
You are. Girl, you are.
It's my husband.
Then I'm gonna use dark cocoa to contour the back of her temples here, forehead and her. What's this place called? Your cheekbones. Cheekbones, yes, that's it. And then underneath her chin.
Ring, love at first sight, but it was blocked by pain. So for you, I'll exceed the top
won't
five
you,
in the
baby,
game.
In the city lights, I swear I hear you call my name. Call my name. There's nothing right. I'm stuck in where your mind.
Banana powder Toe has with some ladies off banana. I think banana looks ashy on its own. If I wanted,
I look like I'm bleaching when I
yeah,
use
if
that.
I wanted to use it on
it's
her
too,
own, I could, but I'm
white.
Not going to do that.
It's too white, but then topaz is a bit too orange.
Basically, you leave the powder to sort of set into the concealer, to sit in the concealer, and then your concealer won't crease. Do you know what I mean? It's to sort of just cook.
I think mine still creases, you know. I just think it's sometimes depends on your skin.
It's true.
Because my under eyes always creases no matter what I use.
Do you know what actually depends? Because if you've got like sort of laugh lines as well, because
yeah.
Laugh, it doesn't matter what you do, you're still going to have
creases. Yeah.
Sometimes I don't feel like you can reduce creasing, but I will never say that you can 100% get rid of creasing. So with the flat side, I'm going to press that in.
Leave it to cook.
Depending if you're going out and you want a really strong, you know, highlight, you can leave it to cook if you want to. If you don't want to, you ain't got time, you don't have to. Let me not lie, I ain't got time. But if I'm going out, I've got the time.
But you don't need to leave it for long though to cook, right?
It depends on you, like really truly, it actually depends on you and what you want to do.
Wow, how long do people leave it for?
I know some people leave it on for 20 minutes.
It's
sort of like, yeah, they might want to go around and do yeah, I know. She does it 20 minutes and she goes around and do what she wants, but it's not that deep.
I even leave it for like maybe just a minute and I'm thinking that's
a minute
too
you
long.
Think that's baking
because it's irritating because you've basically finished your makeup
true.
And you just
and you want
the powder
true. But that's if you've got time
20 minutes
that's
I don't know how
time.
Different they would look if they left it for 20 minutes.
I don't think it would look that different either, I mean, not lie, but everyone's different.
Okay, and she's just cooking.
Hey guys, I'm just cooking in the kitchen.
Cooking the makeup in the kitchen.
Come on.
You
your face now.
Cook me all the way up, honey. Fully cooked. I don't want to be pink in the middle. I want to be black. We're back. We cooked it all the way up for you, honey. All the way.
Okay, now I'm going, after we've cooked and everything, I'm gonna go in with Sleek's contour powder. You all know. Come on, I'm using dark just to make the contour a bit, you know, stronger. Yeah, so you turn. Just follow the natural. Yeah, great. Yeah, see, you're a pro. I didn't have to tell you to suck in. Okay, now suck out so I can just blend out. Yeah. But with this product as well, if you really aren't like a contour pro, please like add products as you go along. So start with a bit and then keep going, because otherwise you're going to find it a bit hard to blend out. But if you ever do feel like you put too much, you can always go over it with powder. So I'm gonna use Max Mineralized Skin Finish Powder in Dark Deep all over her face anyway. So if I do feel like it's a bit too much, I can dumb it down. Suck in. Suck out. And then you wanna go in like circular motions as well to make sure it's dispersed all over that area, not just in one place, otherwise it looks a bit silly. Blend, blend, blend. And don't worry, I will soften that up with the powder after, so don't be scared. And the same with her temples as well and her forehead. Just a little bit, to be honest. Add a bit of dimension. Probably won't really see it too tough, but it's there. Then underneath her jawline. If you've got a slim face, I don't really have to do this, but I think it looks nice anyway. If you've got quite a chubby face, if you do this, it slims down your face, so it's nice to just contour underneath your chin area.
So is mine chubby?
It's not chubby, but I do it anyway. I just think it looks nice. Like, your face just looks chiseled. You know, when it's just everything's just done.
I wish I was a makeup artist.
You can be whatever you want to be.
Oh, I'm not good.
And so people who are aspiring, like, it just takes practice and stuff. To be honest, just teach yourself. Keep up to date. Don't let anyone tell you can't be something, because a lot of people are doing it. That's wrong. If you love makeup, do it. If you love YouTube, do it. If you love cooking, do it. Whatever you love, do it. Yeah. Now I'm going to contour her nose. I'm going to use the Real Techniques.
I can't wait to see how this nose
shadow brush. I'm just gonna go in really like small, like only a little bit. So following the bridge of her nose. You can see what I'm doing. And then you follow it up to her eyebrow. And then you just brush down. Oh my cup, can you see?
Yeah.
Just brush down gently like this. Like I said, I'm not going overboard, because I don't believe she needs to, because she doesn't have a big nose.
You hear that? We now have a big nose.
Yeah, guys. It's my logo. I'm gonna go in with the highlight in the palette and just gently place some on her nose. And then rub in, or sort of dab in fact. Okay, now I'm gonna go in with my blush palette is called Sugar. And it's got all these pretty colours in it. I'm gonna use,
I like the middle one.
This one, you like this one?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna use the middle one. It's called what does that say? Muscovado?
Yeah, Muscovado.
Yeah.
Mary Pondies. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. I'm Danielle Frimpong. I'm a freelance makeup artist. I'm self-taught. I do birthdays, weddings, any occasion, to be honest, and I'm just trying to get out there a bit more. How is it being a makeup artist? Do people always expect you, your face to be beat and like your hair to be nice and everything?
I love being a makeup artist because it's what I like to do. Like, do you know, everyone's got their certain talent or gift. I feel like my God-given talent is makeup. Like, I feel like I can work how I want to. I can enhance someone's face and make them feel more confident. You know what I mean? So that's why I like it. But it's true. A lot of people feel like you should be wearing makeup every day, or, you know, basically every day. No one has time for that. And number two, I wear makeup like twice a week. I don't actually wear makeup, to be honest, unless I'm going out, unless I'm beating someone's face. I personally don't believe that I need to wear makeup every time I go out. So that's how people see my work. Because if you see me on a general day, let me not lie, I'm not wearing makeup. Do you know what I mean? For me, I want to look different, like, on my wedding day.
Yeah, how I, look on a normal, I saw a tweet the other day, and they said, you girls are not going to look different on your wedding day because you wear eyeshadow.
On a normal day as well, if I am doing my makeup, let me not lie, I don't go all out. A lot of the times, I know it sounds crazy, I don't even like to wear lipstick. I don't even like to wear lipstick and stuff sometimes because I just don't, but I still love makeup, but I like to do makeup on other people more than myself, if that makes sense.
Yeah,
really crazy, but that's,
I think makeup is like art. Like, when you're holding a makeup brush, it's like you're kind of painting, 100%, you're recreating someone's 100%. Face.
And obviously, if you want to take care of your skin as well, it's not every day, you might,
it's not every day, cake the face, makeup, and it's like loads of spots and everything underneath. It's true.
So, yeah, that's the first question.
We're so cheesy.
I know, but, you know,
is it expensive being at MUA, like keeping up with current makeup favorites and products? Like, has there ever been a time where a customer or client has been like, don't you have this so-and-so new lipstick from MAC or whatever?
Do you know what? Funny enough, no client has actually ever said to me, oh, do you have this, this, that, blah, blah, blah. Because I feel like when they tell me they look they want, I've already prepped for that look. Even if it's a certain lipstick, or say I haven't got it, I'll try my best to
get it,
go, something like that. With, what did you ask me at first?
Is it expensive being
Yeah, it's very expensive. Every time people see my kit, like, this isn't my full kit. I have a suitcase of, like, makeup. People ask me, how much is your makeup? I can't tell you
anymore. Because you're always expanding.
I can't tell you anymore, but it's expensive and something that you need to keep expanding to, working at, especially because makeup expires. Did you know you're supposed to throw away?
Oh, makeup expires?
Yeah, like, I think you're supposed to throw away your mascara every 3 months.
Mate, I've had mine for maybe even 2 years.
So this is what I'm saying, like, there's loads of things about makeup people actually don't know. There's certain things, obviously, if I'm MUA as well, I have to keep
up. You have to, just in case someone gets to see it.